How have things changed from, say, May or June until now? What have you figured out, and where do you see it going?
Yeah, well, thanks for having me on again as well. It's good to be here. The pandemic really was a curveball for all of us, small business owners, especially in the service industry. With King State, you know, the summer was very trial and error, and it was very much just an idea of trying to figure out how we're going to navigate this solely on our own, because the government, other businesses, everyone kind of was spinning, trying to figure out what's going on. Our governor, as well as our mayor, everyone wasn't on any real page. So we kind of went our own path. We obviously had to abide by all the laws, and we did. And yeah, I mean, from June, July to now September, and even into October and even August, it's a completely different world. You know, we activated a few different things. We stayed in the to-go model for a very long time. We're now open at 50% capacity, even though our governor said we can open up at 100, and we're still seeing 15 to 20% growth from last year, month to month, from August 19 to 20 and so on. So it's been really cool to kind of see, you know, safety protocols as well as putting out quality products and good service kind of all merging.
Yeah.
And all of our regulars and guests have been really supportive, pushing us through. And unfortunately, that's not the case for a lot of people. So we're really grateful.
And there are members of the population that will not go inside. And I don't blame them. Everybody's got their own level of comfort. I've eaten inside in New Jersey a number of times now. Are you seeing people being unwilling to go inside? It sounds like you're not.
Yeah, I mean, I think the spectrum is so wide, right? We have people that think that this is insane. And we have people that think that if you go outside, you're risking life and death at every turn. And I think we have a mixed bag of both. But the good thing about King State is we still have to go. We have online ordering, and we have a full patio. So you can sit outside, you can sit inside, or you could just take it to go. So I think we hit all of those boxes. And so far, I mean, weekends have been jamming, and everything throughout the week's been really solid and stable. And, you know, the first few weeks we thought it was, oh, everything's open again. Everyone's pretty excited. And that was back in August, and insisted for the last 10 or 11 weeks. Well, so it's really exciting.
You know, I wonder, Tim, and I'm not going to lie to you. I mean, I've talked to my own family that if winter comes and New Jersey goes back on full lockdown, Tampa's not sounding too bad. Obviously, I don't know if Tom Brady's been in there, but my guess is you've probably seen a lot of in-migration, people from this area who know that come January, when it's 30 degrees and snowing here, and maybe we go re-lockdown, that Florida could be a very good long-term play. I'm not kidding, because it's 65 degrees and you can be outside.
Yeah, you're not wrong. I mean, we're seeing that already in droves of people from New York. I mean, our residential real estate market is exploding still, and it never really stopped. So, I mean, I think you're dead on there. And I think that, yeah, there's a lot of first timers. There's a lot of regulars, you know, and the spectrum runs the gamut. And then obviously doing stuff like this and people seeing us in Food and Wine, we still a year and a half in have people going, oh, I just heard about you. It's my first time in. So it's really interesting to see things still building even in a pandemic.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.